The Night Manager, an extraordinary piece of television. Can you talk a little bit about why you think it has been the international phenomenon that it has been?
You're right. It kind of, I think everyone was slightly startled by the, you know, there was, we hoped for a positive reaction, but in our wildest dreams, we couldn't have believed the kind of the global reaction that, that The Night Manager garnered. It's an alchemy. It's a, if you try and analyze it, I think you'd struggle, but we'll certainly struggle to come up with a real answer. But I think it's a combination of various things. It was the source material, which is obviously Le Carré, you know, a master of that kind of genre, but you've still got to translate that from the novel to the screen, and people have tried. You know, Hugh wanted to do it in 1992. He wanted to play Pine, and then realized as the years went by that that was less and less likely. But there was still, fortunately for him, a cracking part available in Richard Roper. But it was a combination. We were lucky with the David Farr, who adapted it, hugely lucky with Susanna Beer, who directed it. Hugh and Tom both massively invested in the material, and they were fantastic leading men. The layer upon layer upon layer sort of came together to produce this work, but it's still not a guarantee, which means you don't get complacent. Everybody worked incredibly hard, but I think the key thing about it was the ensemble nature of it, and I mean that not just in terms of the actors, but in terms of the entire production, from production design to costume to direction to music to cinematography. It was a hugely collaborative effort, and that doesn't happen all the time. So everyone was pulling in the same direction, and on many occasions people can pull in different directions, but we were very, very lucky. And if you could bottle that alchemy, then that would be something special. So whether we get to do it again, which is sort of the big question, we hope so. We shall see. There are plans afoot. Whether those plans come to fruition is due down to quite a few variables, but the desire to do it is there from all of us, which is fantastic. So we shall see. I think Hugh is brilliantly cast, partly because he has a great understanding of the material, but you know, Hugh's work is so diverse. He's also got such a fierce intelligence as well, Hugh. And, you know, we've known him in this country for his sort of brilliant and extraordinary work with Stephen Fry and his sort of rubber-faced antics on Jeeves and Worcester. But there's so much more to Hugh in terms of, you know, his sort of acting body of work, let alone the music and everything else that he does. And obviously in House, which was, you know, incredibly complex character. He's a master of material. I sort of keep coming back to that with you. And the great thing about Tom is that Tom is a sort of a leading man in the classic mold, and it's not easy to take on the role of a leading man. There are not only playing the part, a very complex part. You know, Jonathan Pine pretending to be someone else, pretending to be someone else, is very, very tricky. And because you also film things out of sequence, you've got to kind of keep hold of where you are in the story, specifically when you're playing that kind of part. But he embraces the notion of being a leading man, so he leads very, very well, and that is a leading man, the literal definition. But them working together as well is crucial. And this is a sort of an unusual story in the sense that usually you have the good guy and the bad guy, they don't meet until the final reel, whereas in this piece, they meet reasonably early on, and thereby hangs the tale. So there's also a lack of ego as well. And so when we rehearsed every morning, which we did, which is relatively unusual when you're shooting, normally you go straight into it and sort of figure it out in the moment. But we had rehearsal beforehand, and the desire to tell the story was paramount. Rather than, I want this screen time, I need that screen time. The egos that can shine through on certain projects didn't. It was about serving the story and telling the story. And I think that was probably at the heart of one of the sort of details at the heart of the success of the piece, was the desire from both of those leading actors to tell the story, let alone the other people we were blessed with, you know, Olivia, Elizabeth, Tom Hollander, the list goes on.